Yeah. This crude woodcut is titled Massacre of Whites by Blacks and Indians. It shows African Americans in plantation dress and Indians in native costumes. Kathleen Hulser explains its significance.
Here you see graphically represented what was going on in Florida. Notice that the African Americans in the woodcut are wearing American dress, and they seem to be equipped with something like plantation type weapons, maybe a cutlass or a machete. The Indians, on the other hand, are wearing Seminole dress, and they have tomahawks. The Indians who lived in Florida were called the Seminoles, and they welcomed many of the African Americans who were running south to escape slavery. The African American freedom seekers found allies in the Indians who were often fighting the U.S. Army. In fact, there were so many African American slaves who slipped over the border to join the Seminoles that they became known as a band called the Black Seminoles. Looked at an image of a man dressed in Indian costume. He was an example of a Black Seminole. His name is Chief John Horse, and he fought the Americans in several wars as a Seminole. He was also an escaped slave. See how he has adopted the Seminole dress of garters, Indian shirt, and wrapped turban with a beautiful swamp bird feather in it.
You'll see a large map of Florida. Find the border between Florida and Georgia.
If you were an escaping slave, you could very easily lose yourself in a place like the giant Okefenokee Swamp and join in with bands of Indians who knew their way around the area in dugout canoes. The U.S. Army repeatedly tried to subdue the Seminoles in this area, but most of the time they couldn't even find them to fight.
Understand that they must handle journals, government reports, sermons, books, and diaries written by Europeans about Native Americans cautiously, as artifacts of European adjustment to cultural diversity, rather than true guides to Indian societies. This European adjustment has given us a distorted view and has allowed many misconceptions and inaccuracies to be perpetrated. Case in point, most people believe that the existence of dark-skinned people in the United States began with the African slave trade. The truth is, as writer Jack Forbes expresses in his book Africans and Native Americans, many, but not all Native Americans were of a dark complexion without African ancestry. Truth be told, it was the Native American slave trade that placed many dark-skinned Native Americans into slavery. And to keep these facts in obscurity, many books evade the subject of the Native American slave trade. William L. Katz, in his book Black Indians, says it eloquently when he states that omission, not distortion, is the far more serious culprit in hiding the story of the Black Indians of the Americas. Although many attribute the demise of many Native people to diseases that they did not have natural immunities to, one must examine forces other than disease, in particular, the commercial trade in Indian slaves, to the termination of many Southern clans, tribes, and chiefdoms. During exploring expeditions in America, leaders like Hernando de Soto and Ponce de Leon needed a means to reward the services of their soldiers. Since other means of payment were scarce, slavery satisfied this need. Slavery was considered a part of any expedition of discovery and conquest. So, as stated in Indian slavery during colonial times, not to follow such a custom would have been acting contrary to the spirit of the times. We must remember that the tribes that were being enslaved, many from up and down the southeastern coast, were of a dark complexion. In the book Africans and Native Americans, Jack Forbes states, in 1524, the Carolina coast people were said to be of a dark color, not much unlike the Ethiopians. These dark-colored Native Americans were being enslaved and sent by the tens of thousands to the West Indies or retained in the colonies, such as described by Lauber, in 1671, the Coosaw were sent to be sold out of the colony. Also, during the war with the Stono Indians in 1680, the captive Indians were to be carried to the West Indies as slaves. He describes three expeditions from 1702 to 1708 against the Yamasee, Apalachee, and Tamuqua of northern Florida. There was carried back to Charleston for sale as slaves almost the entire population of seven towns. And last in this list, nearly all the Apalachee were distributed as slaves among the Carolina settlers. These scenarios were replicated thousands upon thousands upon thousands of times.